नोटिफिकेशंस।
फर्स्ट लेट्स सी व्हाट इज द स्ट्रैटेजी टू क्वालिफाई दिस एग्जाम इजीली। ओके, यूजीसी एनईटी बोथ द पेपर्स वेरी इजीली। लेट्स सी द स्ट्रैटेजी। वी ऑल नो कमिंग टू दिस पर्टिकुलर एग्जाम देर आर टू डिफरेंट पेपर्स, पेपर वन एंड पेपर टू। वी ऑल नो दैट, राइट? इफ यू वॉन्टेड टू क्वालिफाई इन दिस एग्जाम यू मस्ट गेट 60% इन पेपर वन एंड 60% इन द पेपर टू। ओके, इन ऑर्डर टू क्वालिफाई इन दिस पर्टिकुलर एग्जाम, इन ईच ऑफ द पेपर यू मस्ट इंडिविजुअली गेट 60% ऑफ मार्क्स। ओके, सो नाउ आई विल टेल यू हाउ कैन यू गेट दिस 60% वेरी इजीली विदाउट मच एफर्ट्स। ओके, टू पेपर वन वी ऑल नो देर आर 10 यूनिट्स। ओके, वी ऑल नो कमिंग टू पेपर वन देर आर 10 यूनिट्स एंड फ्रॉम ईच यूनिट 5 क्वेश्चंस विल बी आस्क्ड। 10 यूनिट्स, 10 यूनिट्स एंड 5 क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम ईच यूनिट, सो टोटली 50 क्वेश्चंस, बट हियर आवर टारगेट इज 60%। ओके, सी आउट ऑफ 50 क्वेश्चंस इफ यू वांटेड टू क्वालिफाई दिस पेपर वन स्पेशली यू मस्ट गेट एटलीस्ट 30, यू मस्ट एटलीस्ट डू 30 क्वेश्चंस करेक्टली, यू मस्ट एटलीस्ट आंसर 30 क्वेश्चंस करेक्टली। ओके, टिल हियर यू अंडरस्टूड, राइट? आउट ऑफ 10 यूनिट्स, आउट ऑफ 10 यूनिट्स कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन योर स्ट्रेंथ एरियाज। ओके, आउट ऑफ द 10 यूनिट्स फर्स्ट कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन स्ट्रेंथ एरियाज। ओके, आई एम श्योर आउट ऑफ 10 यूनिट्स एटलीस्ट यू विल बी गुड एट गुड विथ 6 यूनिट्स। ओके, आई एम श्योर दैट। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आउट ऑफ 10 यूनिट्स लेट्स थिंक यू आर वेरी गुड एट 6 यूनिट्स, सो कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन दिस 6 यूनिट्स एंड वी ऑल नो फ्रॉम ईच यूनिट वी विल बी गेटिंग 5 क्वेश्चंस, सो इजिली 30 क्वेश्चंस। द स्ट्रैटेजी इज कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन स्ट्रेंथ टॉपिक्स। Concentrate on strength topics. At least try to answer 30 questions correctly. This is the first strategy. Attempt all the questions. Okay, so how many ever questions are there in the question paper? Don't leave even single question because we all know there is no negative marking. Okay, there is no negative marking. So even though if you don't know the answer also, try to attempt some or the other option. Start solving question paper with easy questions. Okay, so while solving question paper, start solving the paper from the easy questions. See, this is the time, exam time. Divide the exam time into 3 parts. First part of the exam time, give it for easy questions. Second, give it for moderate questions. And last, give for difficult questions, tricky questions, and for guessing. Give this time for difficult questions, tricky questions, and guessing. Okay? In the first one third of the time, concentrate on solving all the easy questions and all the questions which you are very confident with. And second third of the part of exam time, give it for moderate questions. Okay. What are moderate questions? If you read the question twice or thrice, you will know the answer. Okay. Those kind of questions are moderate questions. And third part, that is at the end time of the exam, give it for difficult questions, tricky questions. Tricky questions means the questions which are asked indirectly, which needs a lot of time, those questions, okay? And for guessing, okay? And for guessing. See, let's think, out of 50 questions, you answered only 40 questions, and remaining 10 questions you didn't answer. So at this particular third part of the time, guess all the 10 questions and put some or the other answer, because we clearly know that there is no negative marking, should not even leave one question also blank, okay? And next strategy is skip lengthy questions in the beginning. Skip lengthy questions in the beginning. See, once you start writing your exam, whatever lengthy questions are there, skip them, okay? For example, if one question is taking 3 minutes, instead of solving that one question, go for easy questions which will take 1 minute for one question, okay? So in this particular exam, particularly, time management is really important, and first solve the questions which you know very well, okay? So now let's see what are the last minute preparation tips, okay? This is the strategy, last minute preparation tips, okay? Don't start new topics, okay? When you have only few days left for your exam, it's better only to revise the topics which you have already studied, okay? See, once you start new topics, you can't remember those new topics, and in return, you will also get confusion and you will also forget the topics which you have already learned, okay? So that's why don't start any new topics, okay? And second is, time management is very, very important, okay? If you are getting stuck with any particular question or any particular concept, go to the next question, okay? Even in exam, don't waste your time by getting stuck with single questions. Mock tests are very, very important. Make sure you give your mock tests, okay? Only once you give mock tests, only you'll understand how much time you're taking to solve the paper, and are you getting stuck in any particular topic or question? So all these things you will understand in mock tests, and only with the help of mock tests you will understand what are the common mistakes you are making, so that you will make sure you will not repeat those mistakes in the final exam, okay? So mock tests are very, very important. Read each and every question carefully. Next important tip is, read questions carefully. The few questions will be tricky, and few questions will be asking, like, they'll ask, select the option which does not include, okay? If you didn't read does not or do not option, you will read it as select the option which includes, so that your answer will be wrong and you will lose marks. That's why read every question carefully. Solve at least last 4 to 5 years of previous papers, so you will understand what level of questions are asked in the exam, okay? So next is, always maintain your speed and accuracy. What is speed? We already know it's nothing but time management. Accuracy means, if you are solving 10 questions in 10 minutes and at least 7 questions are correct, then it means you have accuracy, okay? Now I'm going to tell you exam day tip. Coming to exam day tips, don't forget your admit card, ID card also, ID proof also. You need to take a valid ID proof. A valid ID proof means Aadhaar card or voter ID, driving license. All this comes under valid ID proofs. Only valid ID proofs will be allowed in the exam, okay? That's why make sure you carry your admit card, ID card, as well as at least 2 to 3 passport size photos, okay? These are really important. and make sure you reach exam hall, exam center at least before 1 hour. There will be a lot many protocols which you need to undergo, thermal screening, all those things. So it will surely take some time. So better reach your exam center at least before 1 hour of time. Okay. For giving best videos for you people, me and my team is working so much hard for you people. So yeah, please support us. Subscribe and hit the bell icon. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. And all the very best to your exam. Thanks for watching.